The mermaid swam softly about in the crystal green water and dragged after them a fishing net woven of deep sea pearls, she said. The princess sat on the white rock and watched them. It was a wonderful story about a princess who was loved by a prince merman and went to live with him in shining caves under the sea. The small drudge before the grate swept the hearth once and then swept it again. Having done it twice, she did it three times, and as she was doing it the third time, the sound of the story so lured her to listen that she fell under the spell and actually forgot that she had no right to listen at all, and also forgot everything else. She sat down upon her heels as she knelt on the hearthrug, and the brush hung idly in her fingers. The voice of the storyteller went on and drew her with it into winding grottos under the sea, glowing with soft, clear blue light and paved with pure golden sands. Strange sea-flowers and grasses waved about her, and far away faint singing and music echoed. The hearth-brush fell from the work-roughened hand, and Lavinia Herbert looked round.
"That girl has been listening," she said.
The culprit snatched up her brush and scrambled to her feet. She caught at the coal-box and simply scuttled out of the room like a frightened rabbit. Sarah felt rather hot-tempered.
"I knew she was listening," she said. "Why shouldn't she?"
Lavinia tossed her head with great elegance.
"Well," she remarked, "I do not know whether your mamma would like you to tell stories to servant girls, but I know my mamma wouldn't like me to do it."
"My mamma," said Sarah, looking odd, "I don't believe she would mind in the least. She knows that stories belong to everybody."
"I thought," retorted Lavinia in severe recollection, "that your mamma was dead. How can she know things?